Om Shanti. Today is your 58th day of your blessing. And in today's blessing, Baba is actually telling us that being a part of the Brahmin clan, what does a Brahmin clan actually mean? Brahma means Adam or Adam. And being a child of Brahma, actually even you are a child of Brahma. Everybody is a creation of Adam or Brahma. He is the great, 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 great grandfather. And we are all his children. But God had created Adam or Brahma in his own eyes. That means God had given the knowledge of divinity, of power to Brahma. Now, who's a Brahmin? Brahmin is somebody who follows the footsteps of Brahma. And the footsteps which have been defined, the laws have been defined by God the Father himself. So, if you're following Brahma, that means we become Brahmins. Not the ones who know the Shastras, not the ones who have a ponytail over here as a symbol of knowing or learning the Shastras or having the highest knowledge in the world. God says to be humble, to be pure, to be somebody who is completely viceless is the one who can be called a Brahmin, not somebody who has learned the Shastras and is able to recite them. That is not a true Brahmin. So a true Brahmin means to be somebody who is following the footsteps of Brahma. That means to be in Brahmacharya. Brahmacharya doesn't mean that you have to be a celibate only. Brahmacharya means to be in the acharan or to follow the footsteps of Brahma. So let's see what does Baba talk about being a Brahmin today. So Baba says, may you be a lamp of the clan who glorifies the name of the Brahmin clan with the light of your awareness. So, this Brahmin clan is the greatest clan of all, and all you are the lamps of this clan. Why is the greatest clan? It's not that it's the richest or it's got all the different scriptures and you have mugged up all the different shlokas and all the different verses. No. It means that we are full of humility, we are full of divinity, royalty, we are full of kindness, we are full of other virtues, which is politeness, which is full of acceptance for others in the way they are, and many more qualities which have been defined in the link below in the description. You can go and have a look up, and there's a mention of 36 different qualities over there and the 8 powers. So if a soul has got all those powers, then we are actually Brahmins. Then only. Then that means we are following in the footsteps of Adam or Brahma. So Baba says this Brahmin clan is the greatest clan of all. And all of you are the lamps of this clan. To be a lamp of the clan means to be one who always glorifies the name of the Brahmin clan with the light of your awareness. It's like the inner light is on, that I'm soul conscious, so I am following the footsteps of Supreme Soul, who is ever conscious. Conscious about what? About all the qualities and all the powers at every single time. He doesn't come into ego or anger or jealousy or hatred or comparison, never. So he says, once you follow into my footsteps, you follow me. And I impart this knowledge through the means of Brahma. That means I create the new world through the means of Brahma at the end of Iron Age or the Kali Yuga. And when I do that, you also become a light. You also become a light like a lighthouse. You also show other people the path of doing the right actions. To be a lamp of the clan means to be one who always glorifies the name of the Brahmin clan with the light of your awareness. A constant and eternal light means constantly to be an embodiment of remembrance. Remembering who? God and his teachings about how to do the right karmas with the right qualities, with the right powers. And an embodiment of power. If you have the awareness that you are a master almighty authority, then I am powerful enough to fight over the weaknesses within, like lust, anger, greed, ego, attachment, jealousy, hatred, or comparison, or competition, or laziness, or postponement, which we actually follow sometimes in our life. We fall into that trap. So Baba says, I am a master almighty authority. I can win over all these weaknesses within me. You will automatically become an embodiment of power then. The memorial of this eternal and constant light is shown as a constantly lit light in front of your non-living image. So Baba is reminding us that those deities which are there actually belong to the original eternal deity dynasty. So the Hindus who pray to, they pray to whom? They pray to the deities. So they actually belong to the original eternal deity dynasty. Just like those who remember Christ belong to Christian dynasty. Those who remember Buddha belong to Buddhist dynasty. So those who remember deities actually don't belong to Hindu Dharma. There's nobody as Hindu who created this religion. Like Christ created the religion, so it was known as Christian religion. Buddha created the religion, it was known as after him as Buddhist religion. Who's Hindu? There's nobody in the name of Hindu. So Hindus are the ones who have forgotten that they actually belong to the deity dynasty because they pray or they remember or they revere the deities. So they actually belong to the deity dynasty, but now because they have become impure and lustful and angry and greedy, so they can't call themselves as deities anymore, any longer. So they have started calling themselves as Hindus. So Baba says, if you remember that you actually belong to that deity dynasty and you're supposed to get all those qualities back by meditating on me and following Brahma, then you will end up entering into the gates of heaven as a divine human being, also known as a Devi Devta or a God Goddess. Now, deities cannot be gods or goddess because God is only one. So, but they actually imbibe the qualities of God. That's why they have been called by others as God and goddesses. But that is not the right way of calling them. They are actually divine beings who are deities, not gods and goddesses, as per Baba. That's what he teaches us. So there's a light which is actually lit in front of them, and the worshippers, they actually make sure that the light doesn't ever go off in certain temples. So Baba says, just like the light doesn't go off and you actually make sure that the light or the earthen lamp doesn't put off. Similarly, here also, don't put off your awareness that you are a soul, you're God's child, and you have to follow Brahma with all the powers and all the divine qualities. And that is what it means to have the light always lit throughout the world. So I leave you with this beautiful Vardhan. Have a beautiful understanding and a meditative session. Om Shanti.